as in all cancers, the major form of treatment is one, surgery. Second is radiation. Third is what we call chemotherapy. But I prefer to use the word systemic treatment. Systemic treatment, including chemotherapy, hormone treatment, targeted therapy. It also includes things like tablets or intravenous injections. For non-small cell lung cancer, the main treatment that has a curative potential that can cure patients will be surgery. But surgery is only feasible or useful for patients who present with early disease. For non-small cell lung cancers, only about 20% of all newly diagnosed lung cancers belongs to stage 1-2. For the other 40% of patients actually present with locally advanced disease. What we mean is the disease is localized within the thorax, has not spread to outside the thorax, but they have big lymph nodes or the tumor is big. In those patients, the main treatment will be radiation. For the other last 40% of patients who present with advanced disease, with disease that is widespread, involving the bone, involving the liver, the main treatment will be systemic treatment and usually it's chemotherapy.
The sad truth of it is that the large majority of lung cancer patients present with advanced stage disease. 85% of all the lung cancers we see present in either late stage 3 or stage 4, whereby treatment has no curative potential, where the main aim of treatment is merely to kill the cancer, control the disease, improve the quality of life, and prolong life. Let me show you some examples. This is a gentleman who came to see us. As you can see, he has a very large lung cancer involving the right lung, and there's also disease on the other side. As the cancer has spread from one lung to the other, it is classified as stage 4 lung cancer. When he came to see us, he was very symptomatic, coughing, having hemoptysis, in other words, blood in his sputum, and very breathless. After treatment, you can see the small nodules on the left side have improved significantly and disappeared, and on the right side, the big mass has shrunken in size. In this particular patient, we were able to relieve him of his symptoms, help to control his disease, and he lived for a few more months, a few more years, and then eventually he passed away. So, in stage 4 disease, while we are often unable to cure them of the cancer, we are able, in most cases, to help to improve their quality of life and to help prolong life. There is now data to show that in patients who have undergone surgery for lung cancer, even though the full staging evaluation shows no evidence of cancer spread, the tumor has already been removed, on evaluation, everything is okay. By adding on 4 cycles of chemotherapy or 6 cycles of chemotherapy, there's actually data to suggest that these patients have a higher chance of cure. The purpose of the chemotherapy is to treat the microscopic disease and eradicate the microscopic disease such that there's a lower chance of cancer recurrence. One of the biggest advancements in the treatment of lung cancer is the development of new drugs. We now have what we call targeted cancer therapies. Because of the many, many years of research, we are beginning to understand more about the genetics, the molecular basis upon which these cancers grow. We are now often able to alter it at the molecular level, causing the cancer cells to die. One of the drugs which has made a major impact in terms of treatment of lung cancer are these small molecules called TKIs. These TKIs, an example is IRESA. Let me show you this example. This is a lady from Indonesia, where you can see this is the heart, and you can see both the lungs are studded full of cancer nodules. In this one cut alone, you can count no less than 50 nodules. If you add up all the nodules in the lungs, I wouldn't be surprised if it adds up to almost 1,000 cancer nodules. And because these cancer nodules destroy the normal lung structure, the patient is obviously coughing badly and very breathless. Combining chemotherapy with these TKIs, all right, you can see the dramatic response. Right? The lungs literally open up again. When we first saw this patient in October of 2005, she was very, very symptomatic. And now, in June 2007, she is completely well, able to function normally, continue working, all right, and having good quality life. You can see that through the development of new drugs, we are now able to tackle the cancer, and the best news of it all is that it's minimal side effects.